It's nighttime in the big city. A girl goes through the medicine cabinet of the man who brought her home. A ringing phone goes unanswered. It's theme time radio hour with Bob Dylan.
Gather round, friends, for it is time to speak of that most serious of subjects, the good book, the testaments both old and new, the law, the word from on high. I'm talking about the Bible, and you better listen. For the next hour, we're going to be playing music about Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, and Numbers, Deuteronomy, and Joshua, Judges, the wisdom of Solomon. 1 Maccabees and 2 Maccabees, 1 Samuel and 2 Samuel, 1 Kings, 2 Kings. We're going to be playing stuff that comes out of the Psalms and the Proverbs. You know all of these, Jonah and Malachi. How come nobody's named Malachi anymore? We're going to be playing music that has something to do with Nehemiah, Esther, Job, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And of course, the Book of Revelations. So gather the family around the radio. And hear the good news. Seek and you shall find. Let's open up to chapter 1. Are you bound for heaven or hell?
I'm going to talk to you this morning from a subject. Where are you bound?
Amen.
Are you bound for heaven or hell?
Amen.
I hear so many people talking about their leader.
Yes.
These little old preachers don't know A from B.
Amen.
Talking about they got a great congregation. And they're leading them. I know they're leading them.
Yes.
But leading them from where? To where?
All right, God.
And say we're going, yes, I believe they're going.
Yes.
But where are you going to?
So true.
Who are your leader?
Yes.
Your leader doesn't know anything.
No, it doesn't.
And now where are you going?
All right,
you
God.
Say, I'm bound
yes.
for the promised land.
Yes.
But you make me think about an old freight train.
Yes.
That was going north one day.
Yes.
And I noticed that she had come uncoupled.
God Almighty.
And the cars were going south.
So
an angel was going north.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. You can't tell me
yes.
that you're going to heaven when you just keep backing off the hill.
Amen.
I don't believe
Amen.
When you're bound,
Amen.
But you're bound for hell.
Yes.
Except you be born again.
Born again.
That's all it is about. I don't care who you are
yes.
or where you come
That's
from.
All right.
Except you know Jesus.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
In the free pardon of your sins.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
You got to know
Come on,
when
yes.
your feet were sticking out the mud and mud
yes.
placed on a rock
Talk to me.
Of eternal lady.
Yes.
You got to remember the very hour.
Yes.
I want to ask Deacon Davis,
yes.
take our case to the throne of grace.
Yes.
Everybody moan
yes.
deep down in their soul.
That was Reverend J.M. Gates. He ministered at Atlanta's Calvary Church and first recorded in 1926. He recorded over 200 sides. He once recorded 23 titles in 1 week. Reverend J.M. Gates, are you bound for heaven or hell? He's not the only Gates who's a fan of religion. Microsoft founder Bill Gates recently spent $30 million to purchase an authentic Gutenberg Bible. Some people have to choose between heaven and hell, and other people have other choices to make. Here are the Yahoos, at the crossroads between the bottle and the Bible. They're stopping by the liquor store on the way to revival, heading down the road with a bottle and a Bible. They took a little longer than they hoped it would. They want to thank the Lord for treating them good. Here are the Yahoos, the bottle and the Bible.
Hope it would.
was The Bottle in the Bible by the Yahoos, a song written by Terry Anderson and Dan Baird. Dan was in the group The Georgia Satellites, and guitarist Eric Amble currently also plays with Steve Earle. That was from their 2001 album, Fear Not the Obvious. And if you have to choose between The Bottle and the Bible, you might be needing a 12-step program, which was started by Bill Wilson, who helped spread the idea that drinking was a disease. If you feel 12 steps aren't enough for you, may I recommend the Alfred Hitchcock classic, The 39 Steps.
Cigarette cases, yes, but I've never seen it happen to a hymn book before, except on the movies.
And this bullet stuck among the hymns, eh? Well, I'm not surprised. Some of those hymns are terrible hard to get through. I've stuck at them myself before now, eh? Well, it's a lesson to us all, Mr. Haney, not to mix with doubtful company on the Sabbath.
If you have to go higher than 39 steps, just remember, one might be too many, and 100 might not be enough. The Bible is full of great stories, and a lot of them have been put to music. Like this one, the story of Samson and Delilah. Samson is described in the book of Judges as something of a Herculean figure, utilizing massive strength. In chapter 16, he goes to Gaza, where he falls in love with Delilah at the Brook of Sorek. The Philistines approach Delilah and induce her to try to find the secret of Samson's strength. She asks him four times, and three times he gives her a false answer. The fourth time, he tells her the truth. He does not cut his hair in fulfillment of a vow to God. Delilah betrayed him to his enemies. He was captured by the Philistines, who gouged out his eyes. They cut his hair and imprisoned him. Samson prayed to the Lord, "O sovereign Lord, please strengthen me just once more, and let me with one blow get revenge on the Philistines." And down came the temple and all the people in it.
If I had my way, if I had my way, if I had my way, I would tear this old building down. Where Delilah, she was a woman, she was fine and fair. She had good looks, God knows, and cool black hair. Delilah, she gained old Samson mind. The first he saw this woman, it just be this time. Delilah, she sat down with Samson knee, to tell him that you straight lie, if you please. She spoke so kind, God knows she talked so fair. Just Samson said, Delilah, cut off my hair. You can shave my head, clean in my hand, if my strength come larger, is any other man. If I had my way, yeah, if I had my way, if I had. So building down, great God my token. Yes, sir. Yeah. Talk to me now. Talk. Uh-huh. Talk. Uh-huh. Talk to me. Let me hear. Talk to me. Make me feel good. What? Talk to me. Uh-huh. Well, you read about old Samson, all from his grave. He was the strongest man that ever had lived on earth. So one day while Samson was walking along, he looked on the ground and saw an old jawbone. He stretched out his arm, God knows it broke like thread. When he got to move it, 10,000 were dead. Good God, if I had my way, if I had my way, If I had my way, I would tear this old building down. Well, old Samson in the line got in attack. Samson, he jumped up on the lion back. So you'll read about this lion had killed a man with his paws. But Samson, he got his hand in the lion's jaws. He reared that beast until he killed him dead. And that beast made honey that lion hit. If I had my way, if I had my way, if I had my way, I would tell it so. Ow! If I had my way, if I had my way, if I had my way, I would. Good God.
That was Reverend Gary Davis tearing the whole building down with his song Samson and Delilah. Like a lot of other street performers, he always put gospel songs in among his blues to make it harder for the police to interrupt him. He began taking gospel more seriously, and in 1937, he became an ordained minister. After that, he usually refused to perform any blues. Kitty Wells was one of the few country stars that was actually born in Music City. She was born in Nashville, Tennessee in 1918. She met her future husband, Johnny Wright, Mr. Wright, of Johnny and Jack, and it was him who gave her the stage name, taken from an old folk ballad called I'm a Gonna Marry Kitty Wells. She began touring as part of Johnny and Jack's show and had a number of hits on her own. In 1974, she was inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame, deservedly so. She sings a song here about a vengeful God who will set your fields on fire.
There's a call that rings for the one who sings to those now gone astray. Saying, come ye. Seem to heed at the chain of greed, your conscience never tires. Be assured, my friend, if you still offend, he will set your fields on fire. If you don't from sin retire, he will set your fields on fire. You have heard Jesus call, and in death your soul must fall. Heavenly choir, and rejoice with him, free from every sin, when he sets this world on fire. You have heard his voice, seen the souls rejoice that trusted in his grace. You have blushed with sin, and he knocked with. But still you hide your face from the blessed Lord and his own true word. But still you say retire. Leave the downward path, kindle not his wrath, or he'll set your fields on fire. If you don't from sin retire, he will set your fields on fire. You have heard Jesus call.
That was Kitty Wells singing He Will Set Your Fields on Fire. Another story of a vengeful Lord is Exodus chapter 30, verses 7 through 10, where Moses has to talk God out of exterminating the whole nation of Israel. But not every story from the Bible is so serious. Theme Time Radio Hour favorite Wynonie Harris has a lighthearted look at the Garden of Eden with a song called Adam, Come and Get Your Rib. She's been cheating, she's been lying, she's got my poor heart crying. This is Wynonie Harris.
Adam, come and get your rib. I think she's too much for me to own. She's been cheating, she's been lying, now she's got my poor heart crying. Adam, come and get your bone. I know if you had to do it again, you'd leave them apples alone. The way these women treat these men, you shouldn't have gave them your bone. So Adam, come and get your bone. Come and take what's rightfully your own. Place your spare rib where you found it, put a lock and chain around it. Adam, come and get your bone. Cause she's got a heart just like stone. I have finally made my mind up. She's yours in a bind of wind up. Adam, come on and get your bone. I wish you could see your spare rib now, looking like something she ain't. She's all disguised with bloodshot eyes, lipstick, powder, and paint. So Adam, come and get your rib. She has made my poor heart weep and moan. I guess I've learned my lesson, with them apples I don't be messing. So Adam, come get your creepy bone.
That was Wynonie Harris with a personal plea to Adam. Come and get your rib, come and get your bone. In 1646, the philosopher Sir Thomas Brown published a work which included the question about Adam and Eve's navels. Basically, there was a controversy which said that if Adam and Eve were born of God and not of man, they should not be depicted in portraits with navels. But most paintings by Renaissance masters, such as Michelangelo or Raphael, clearly showed them that both had navels. All things to all men. And the rest is history. Another one of the most famous stories in the Bible is Noah's Ark, and here it's sung about by A.A. Gray and 7 Foot Dilly. I know what you're thinking. That's a heck of a name, but let me explain. Guitarist John Dillashaw was 6'7" and was known as 7 Foot Dilly. He recruited some of the best fiddlers in the area, such as Lowe Stokes, Harry Kiker, Joe Brown, and A.A. Gray. Together, they recorded this song. Noah and the devil are playing 7-up. The devil wins the ark, but Noah won't give it up. The old ark's a-moving.
Noah built the ark out of gopher wood. The flood, it came in, the ark, it stood. And old ark's a-moving, a-moving, a-moving. And old ark's a-moving, a-moving along. Who built the ark?
Oh, Noah, Noah.
Now who built the ark? Oh, Noah, my lord. And old ark's a-moving, a-moving, a-moving. And old ark's a-moving, a-moving along. He marched the animals 2 by 2, the hippopotamus and the kangaroo. And old ark's a-moving, a-moving, a-moving. Old ark's a-moving, a-moving along. Who built the ark?
Oh, Noah, Noah.
Now who built the ark? Oh, Noah, my lord. No ark's a-moving, a-moving, a-moving. No ark's a-moving, a-moving along. Noah and the devil playing 7-up. The devil win the ark and Noah wouldn't give it up. No ark's a-moving, a-moving, a-moving. No ark's a-moving, a-moving along. Who built the ark?
Oh, Noah, Noah.
Who
build the ark. Oh, no, my Lord, no dark's a-moving, 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 no dark's a-moving, a-moving along. I know it sent a dove to find dry land. The dove came back with a big grain of sand. No logs are moving, moving, moving. No logs are moving, moving along. Who built the ark?
Oh, no, no.
Now who built the ark?
Oh, no, my Lord.
No logs are moving, moving, moving. No logs are moving, moving along. Had no hat, had no crown, looked like a poor man living in town.
No land's a-moving, a-moving, a-moving,
no dark's a-moving, a-moving along. Who built the ark?
Oh, no, and no.
Now who built the ark?
Oh, no, my Lord.
No dark's a-moving, 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 no dark's a-moving, a-moving along. Had no buggy, had no spokes, I looked like Grandpap and all of his folks.
No logs are moving, a moving, a moving, no logs are moving, a moving along.
Who built the ark?
Oh, no, and no.
Now who built the ark?
Oh, no, and my Lord.
No logs are moving, a moving, a moving, no logs are moving, a moving along. Had no hat, had no brim, looked like a crow's nest swinging on a limb.
No dark's a-moving, a-moving, a-moving,
no dark's a-moving, a-moving along. Who built the ark?
Oh, no, and no.
Now who built the ark?
Oh, no, and my Lord.
No dark's a-moving, 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 no dark's a-moving, a-moving along. Tell Sister Mary, tell Sister Jane, I'll be home on that morning train.
No dark's a-moving, 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 no dark's a-moving, a-moving along.
He built the ark.
That was the old ark's a-moving. And as it says in Genesis 6:14, the vessel was to be made with planks of gopher wood. And after 220 days, the ark came to rest. Noah sent out a raven, which went to and fro, until the waters were dried up from the earth. Noah sent a dove out, but it returned, having found nowhere to land. Noah waited 7 more days, and again sent out the dove. This time it returned, with an olive leaf in its beak, and he knew the waters had subsided. Life could go on. Next up, Washington Phillips. He was a pioneering gospel performer of the 20s. Recorded only 18 songs, but boy, what songs. He was a traveling preacher who accompanied himself on an unusual instrument. Some say it was a dulciola, which is a zither-like instrument with a small keyboard. But other people say it was a modified zither. And some people even say that he played 2 different instruments. One with his left hand and one with his right. In any event, it creates a unique sound. Some of the most distinctive of all early gospel is the Denomination Blues by Washington Phillips.
I want to tell you the natural fact. Every man don't understand the Bible like. But that's all now. I tell you that's all. But you better have Jesus. I tell you that's all. Well, denominations has no right to fight. They ought to just treat each other right. And that's all. I tell you that's all. But you better have Jesus. I tell you that's all. The primitive Baptists, they believe you can't get to heaven unless you wash your feet, but that's all now. I tell you that's all, but you better have Jesus. I tell you that's all. The only primitive that has any part is the one that's after washing with a pure heart, and that's all now. I tell you that's all, but you better have Jesus. I tell you that's all. Now the missionary Baptists, they believe, go under the water and not to wash his feet, and that's all. I tell you that's all. But you better have Jesus now. I tell you that's all. Now the ME Methodists, they believe, sprinkle the head and not to wash the feet, and that's all. I tell you my soul. But you better have Jesus. I tell you my soul. Now the M.E. Methodists, they believe, sprinkle the head and not to wash the feet in their soul. I tell you my soul. But you better have Jesus now. I tell you my soul. Now the African Methodists, they believe the same, cause they know denomination ain't a thing but a name, and that's all. Now, I tell you not all, but you better have Jesus now. I tell you not all. Now the holiness people, when they came in, they said, boys, we can make it by living above sin, but that's all. I tell you not all, but you better have Jesus now. I tell you not all. Now the church of God has it in the mind that they can get to heaven without the sacrament wine, but that's all now. I tell you not all, but you better have Jesus now. I tell you not all.
You can go to your college, you can go to your school, but if you don't have Jesus, you're an educated fool. That was Washington Phillips. The Denomination Blues. There's a lot of mysteries in the Bible, but none of them are any more mysterious than the story of Washington Phillips. There was a story that Washington was committed to a state mental institution less than a year after his last 78 was recorded. But some people say that he actually moved to Simsbury, Texas, and lived there till 1954. When he died from injuries sustained in a fall at the age of 74. Whatever story you choose to believe, we do know he never recorded again after the late 20s. This is the Time Radio Hour, the Bible Edition. Last week we talked about Sid Nathan.
Give me the song.
Here's another little fact about him. He didn't just own King Records, he owned a music publishing company. And he loved getting more bang for his buck. He loved convincing the country music artists to record R&B songs, and vice versa. Wynonie Harris, who we heard a little while ago, recorded Hank Penny's Bloodshot Eyes. Both artists were on Nathan's King label. Another artist on Nathan's label was Reno and Smiley. They had a hit with their song, I'm Using My Bible as a Road Map. When Sid Nathan signed the four interns to King Records, he had them re-record I'm Using My Bible. And they did it a little differently than the Reno and Smiley country style. Here's what it sounded like when Reno and Smiley did it.
I'm using my Bible for a road map. My last stop is heaven some sweet day.
And here's a slightly different version by the four interns. Give a listen. Take it away, Doctor.
Lord, I'm using my Bible for a road map. The Ten Commandments tell me what to do. The 12 disciples are my road signs. And Jesus will take me safely through. There'll be no detours in heaven. No rough roads along the way. Yes, I'm using my Bible for. Well, yeah, my last stop is heaven some sweet day. Well, I know I'll see along the way many sinners who have gone astray. It's hikers along the roadside, but I know it's the devil in disguise. I know I may run out of gas, but the power of the Lord will last. Yes, I'm using
my Bible.
Yeah, yeah, my last stop is heaven someday. Bible for a road map. The children of Israel used it too. I know they crossed the Red Sea of destruction. For God
Bible road.
Hey, no,
my last stop is heaven some sweet day. My last stop is heaven some sweet day.
I'm using my Bible for a road map by the four interns. There are over 20 million Bibles distributed every year, and the Bible can be read aloud in 70 hours, though you might want to take a nap between the Old and New Testaments. 9 out of every 10 Americans own at least one Bible. What's up with the other guy? One person you'd be surprised to hear talk about the Bible is Keb Mo. Listen to what he has to say.
When I look at the Bible and they say this is the book about God's word, I don't think God is that confusing. Why would God write such a confusing book? I think it's written by men trying their best to interpret the word of God. But everything's the word of God because we're all a product of God. I mean, I think God has showed up in many, many books. God's showed up in songs. You know, God has showed up in a lot of places. So I think the Bible gets too much credit for being the only word of God.
Here's a song written about Elijah. It's a traditional song performed here by Olabel and New York Band, led by Amy Helm, daughter of Levon Helm. Here's Olabel and their version of Elijah Rock.
Elijah Rock, shout, shout. Elijah Rock, come and upload. Elijah Rock, shout, shout. Elijah Rock, come and upload. Satan is a liar and a conjurer too. If you don't watch out, he'll conjure you. If I could, I surely would stand on the rock where Moses stood. Elijah Rock, shout, shout. Telephone
That's Amy Helm with Ola Bell and their version of Elijah Rock. The record put out by T-Bone Burnett. He's always been a man of great taste. Thank you, T-Bone. Elijah is a heroic figure in Jewish tradition. Every Passover, a special cup of wine is filled and put on the table. The door of the house is left open and a chair is left empty in case Elijah the prophet decides to come in and join the festivities.
How long will you refuse to humble yourself before God?
If you bring another plague upon us, it is not your God but I who will turn the Nile red with blood.
If there is one more plague on Egypt, it is by your word that God will bring it. And there shall be so great a cry throughout the land that you will surely let the people go.
Next up on Theme Time Radio Hour, we're going to visit the rivers of Babylon, as sung about by the Melodians, a vocal trio who are considered one of Jamaica's greatest rock steady groups. In this song, they talk about the rivers of Babylon. The song Rivers of Babylon is based on the biblical hymn Psalm 137 that expresses the yearnings of the Jewish people in exile following the conquest of Jerusalem in 586 BC. The Melodians version, on the other hand, is from 1969 AD.
By the rivers of Babylon, where he sat down,
Rivers of Babylon by the Melodians. The rivers of Babylon are considered the Euphrates River, its tributaries, and the Chiba River. The name Babylon comes from Babalu, which means the gate of God. It is an ancient city on the Euphrates River, about 50 miles south of modern Baghdad. The Book of Revelation, or the Apocalypse of John, is the last canonical book of the New Testament. It is the only biblical book that is wholly composed of apocalyptic literature. The book is frequently called by the incorrect name, the Book of Revelations. However, the actual title of the book is the Revelation of Jesus Christ unto his servant John, as it is rendered in the first verse. And here's Blind Willie Johnson, one of the greatest bottleneck slide gospel blues guitarists, to put the story of John the Revelator to music.
Well, who's that riding?
John the Revelator.
Who's that riding?
John the Revelator.
Who's that riding?
John the Revelator.
Hey, book of the seven, tell me what's John a riding?
John the Revelator.
What's John a riding?
John the Revelator.
What's John a riding?
Master Revelator.
Hey, book of the seven. Father, who by the wife has cried a holy, bound and fold, son of our God, daughter of Zion, Judith the Lion, he redeemed the saint that bought us with his blood. Tell me, who's that a riding?
John the Revelator.
Who's that a riding?
John the Revelator.
Who's that riding?
John the Revelator.
Hey, book of the seven. Well, what's John a riding?
Master Revelator.
What's John a riding?
Master Revelator.
What's John a riding?
Master Revelator.
Hey, book of the seven. John the Revelator, great advocator. Catch them on the Fatima's eye. For telling the story, rising the glory, cried, Lord, to the love of Samaya. Tell me, who's that riding?
John the Revelator.
Who's that riding?
John the Revelator.
Who's that riding?
John the Revelator.
Hey, book of the seven. Well, what's John the riding?
Master Revelator.
What's John a riding?
Master Revelator.
What's John a riding?
Master Revelator.
Hey, book of the seven seals. Well, Moses, watching the flock, saw the bush where they had to stop. God told Moses, pull off his shoes, out of the flock, well, you are shoes. And tell me, who's that a riding?
John the
Who's that riding?
John the Revelator.
Who's
that
riding?
John the Revelator.
Hey, book of the seven. Well, what's John a riding?
Master Revelator.
What's John a riding?
Master Revelator.
What's John a riding?
Master Revelator.
Hey, book of the seven. Well, who are we? Elders cry the holy. Bound and fold, son of our God, daughter of Zion, Judah the Lion, he redeemed us and he bought us with his blood. Tell me, who's that riding?
John the Revelator.
Who's that riding?
John the Revelator.
Who's that riding?
John the Revelator.
Hey, book of the seven seals.
That was John the Revelator by Blind Willie Johnson. We got an email from an R. McGuinn from Kissimmee, Florida. He writes, Dear Bob, congratulations on the show. I understand you're going to do one about the Bible. I've always been partial to a particular set of verses. Can you guess what they are? Sincerely yours, R. McGuinn. Well, R., thanks for writing, and I got a pretty good idea what you're talking about. I'm guessing it's Ecclesiastics. Verses 3, chapters 1 through 8. To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get, a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. I bet that's what you were thinking of. Am I right? Next up, Jess Willard. Jess was named after a boxer who took the heavyweight championship away from Jack Johnson. Jess Willard hooked up with cowboy singer Jack Guthrie, and Guthrie became his chief musical influence. After Jack Guthrie died of tuberculosis in 1948, Willard vowed to carry on his music. I think he did a pretty good job, like this song, Woogie Woogie Preachin' Man, from 1951.
Will you tell about a preaching man from Tennessee who meets his congregation neath that old oak tree? And when he gets the chillin' gathered round, he tells about the Bible and the love he's found. So if you want to see that Beulah land, then listen to the Boogie Woogie Preaching Man. He preaches every Sunday, Monday, Friday too, or any time at all. And if you asked him why he does, he'll say you gotta answer when you hear the call. He rides around the country on an old round mule. He keeps the neighbors living by the golden rule. He says, now listen, brother, sister too, you better be repenting everything you do. Come on and get religion while you can, and get it from the Boogie Woogie Preaching Man. The Boogie Woogie Preaching Man, he's got that old religion you can understand. And when you hear him shouting hallelujah, you're gonna stop your sinning, brother, sister too. You'll walk right up and take him by the hand and say, I'm glad to meet you, Mr. Preacher Man. He never takes a nickel, wouldn't take a dime to wash your sins away. But when he drives old Satan out, you know that you'll be ready for the judgment day. He tells about a place awaiting down below, for if you keep a sinning there, you're sure to go. A dealing cards and chasing late at night. Now listen to me, brother, well, that just ain't right. So if you want to reach that promised land, then listen to the Boogie Woogie Preaching Man. If you want to reach that Beulah land, then listen to the Boogie Woogie Preaching Man.
That was Jess Willard, or as he called himself, a plain old country boy. He wrote the song, Honky Tonk Hardwood Floor, that Johnny Horton had a hit with, and he was heard here with Jimmy Bryant and Speedy West. There are 66 books in the Bible, 1,189 chapters, 31,101 verses. There are 1,260 promises. There are over 8,000 predictions. There are 6,468 commands. The Bible's been translated into over 1,200 languages. The shortest verse in the Bible is just two words long. It's John chapter 11, verse 35. Jesus wept. There are a lot of tears in the Bible, and here are the Swan Silver Tones telling Mary not to cry with their great song from the VJ record label, Oh Mary, Don't You Weep.
Oh, I'm singing Mary.
Oh, Mary, don't you weep.
Martha, don't have to mourn.
Oh, Martha, don't you mourn.
Listen to me, Mary.
Oh, Mary, don't you weep.
Martha, don't have to mourn.
Oh, Martha, don't you mourn.
Pharaoh's army,
oh, Mary, don't you weep.
They got drowned in the sea one day. But Jesus said, Mary,
oh, Mary, don't you weep.
Your little sister don't have to mourn,
oh,
no more.
Don't you mourn.
Now can I get a witness? He said, Mary,
oh, Mary, don't you weep.
Martha don't have to mourn.
Oh, Martha, don't you mourn.
It may be somebody sick today.
Oh,
if somebody here ain't got no home.
Oh, Martha, don't you
but listen,
mourn.
Pharaoh's army,
oh, Mary, don't you
They got drowned in the sea
down in one the day.
But I believe a man said, me,
oh, baby, don't you be.
Your little sister don't have to mourn no
oh,
more.
Don't you mourn.
Now listen, if I could right
yep.
now,
I could.
I wanna tell you that I surely would now.
Oh,
put my foot on the rock,
children.
Stand on the rock where Moses stood one day. Because Pharaoh's eye, that's what the Bible said, got drowned in the sea.
Down in one
day. But I believe the man said,
Mary.
He said,
Mary.
He said,
Mary.
Trouble in the land will be all over after a while. You won't have to give up right for wrong no more. And maybe it could have been a little hard to hear. And I believe Jesus said I better call a little bit louder.
Baby, don't you weep.
Wish I had somebody to help me call me.
Baby, don't
you
weep.
Yeah,
baby.
Yeah,
baby.
I'll be your bridge over deep water if you trust in my name.
Baby,
I'll be your rock in a weary land. Tell Martha don't have to mourn no more.
That was the Reverend Claude Jeter with the Swan Silvertones, a big influence on Al Green. And if you listen closely to that song, you might have heard Claude Jeter say, I'll be a bridge over deep water if you trust in my name. A phrase that inspired Paul Simon a few years later to write some song. So many things you hear every day originate from the Bible. How many times have you heard going on the straight and narrow? You ever say to somebody you're done with something and want to wash your hands of it? An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. Seek and you shall find. Look before you leap. Reap what you sowed. Turn the other cheek. And the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil. That's in the Bible. We got time for one more on tonight's show. This one's by the Robins, biblical in scope, rhythm and blues in nature. This is the kind of Bible study you don't get in Sunday school, where cats are mowing hay through a rubber hose and the women are wearing transparent clothes. This is where Moses said to the old Pharaoh, you'll have to let my people go. That's what the good book says, by the Robins.
Now back in the day, the bull came out every night for the crazy ball. The cats smoking hay through a rubber hose, and the women, they wore transparent clothes.
That's what the good book said, boy. That's what the good book said, boy.
Now Moses said to old Pharaohs, you'll have to let my people go. If you don't take the change off and set them loose, I'm going to put the plague on all of you Jews.
That's what the good book said, boy. That's what the good book said, boy.
Now the snake said to Eve, you listen to me. Go and take that apple off the tree. Now the Lord tried to guide him, but he was blind. She said, this apple cider tastes mighty fine.
That's what the good book said, boy. That's what the good book said.
So they were taking that and brim and mixing with wine and having this
myself a real crazy time.
That's what the good book says, boy. That's what the good book says, boy. That's what the good book says, boy. That's what the good book says.
That was the Robins, who later on became the Coasters. That's what the good book says. And what's a rhythm and blues gospel song without a vibraphone solo? That one probably played by Johnny Otis.
H-A-T-E. It was with this left hand that old brother Cain struck the blow that laid his brother low. L-O-V-E. The right hand, friends, the hand of love. Now watch and I'll show you the story of life. These fingers, dear hearts, is always a warring and a tugging one against the other. Now watch him. Old brother left hand. Left hand hates a fightin', and it looks like love's a goner. Wait a minute. Hot dog, love's a winning. Yes, sirree, it's love that won. And old left hand hate is down for the count.
Well, it's time for me to say goodbye and turn the other cheek and head out of the Abernathy building, down the street, past the church, and down to Samson's Diner. And in the meantime, eat, drink, and be merry, and forgive them, for they know not what they do. We'll see you next week on Theme Time Radio Hour. Amen.
You've been listening to Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan. Produced by Eddie Gorodetsky. Associate producer, Sonny Webster. Continuity by Eats Martin. Edited by Damian Rodriguez. Supervising Editor Rob McComber. The Theme Time Research Team, Diane Lapson and Bernie Bernstein. With additional research by Lynn Sheridan, Kimberly Williams, and Robert Bauer. Production assistance by Jim McBean. Special thanks to Randy Azrati, Debbie Sweeney, Coco Shinomiya, and Samson's Diner. For XM Radio, Lee Abrams. Recorded in Studio B, the Abernathy Building. This has been a Greywater Park production in association with Big Red Tree. This is your announcer, Pierre Mancini, speaking. Join us again next week for Theme Time Radio Hour, and the subject is Musical Map.
Remember, blessed are the peacemakers.
What was that?
I don't know.
I think it was blessed are the cheesemakers.